Hi children. Happy morning. Are you ready? Yeah. Welcome to this art class. As the squad says, art speaks when words are unable to explain. Yes. Images can have meaning far beyond words. Yeah. They become part of a universal language understood by all. In ancient times, people used to express their feelings through the art. Today, I have come up with a folk art that is called Madhubani art, which is a form of art that comes under the folk art. This form of art is actually originated in India, especially people in the Nepal and Bihar practice this type of art efficiently. Now, take a look at these pictures. These are some of Madhubani paintings. Usually, in this art, they won't leave any space. They fill the painting with flowers, leaves, or even geometrical patterns. To draw this art, first take a paper and a pencil. First step is draw a fish outline like this. Hope you all know how to draw a fish with fins. Okay, now draw a round eye in the front side. Make sure to draw the round eye like this because highlighting the eye is important in this Madhubani painting. Okay. Next step is draw two lines on both the front and back side of the body. And then draw 2 to 3 straight lines on the tail. Later, draw a curve on the front end of each fins. And draw a line on the back end of each fins like this. More or less, it will connect the line on the body which we had drawn before. Now, on the body, draw some curves like this. Make sure that the curves won't cross the lines on both sides. Now, you are going to add detailed design on this structure. Draw small curves besides those two lines. And followed by that, draw two wavy lines like this. Later on the fins, draw small and big ovals like this. Now, inside those big curves on the body, you are going to draw a 3 continuous small curve like this, which will add more detailed design and make this different from other art. Now, it's time to paint your picture. For this, take a brush, paints, and your palette. Colors used in Madhubani paintings are always special. Why? Because they use natural colors, which gives uniqueness to that painting. Start by painting inside the parallel lines with dark blue color. Use sky blue color for the head and small part on the end of the body to paint. Then, with the help of a yellow color, draw stripes on the dark blue part like this. Paint the oval part on the body with the orange color. Use red color to paint on the last part of the tail and also on the curves, which is in the body by leaving the inside design. Paint the fins and tail using a green color. Now, paint the left out space on the fins and the body using a violet color. Then paint inside the wavy lines using a yellow color. Finally, in the center, use yellow color to paint. Wow! You have completed your Madhubani painting. Awesome, children! You did a great job. Keep it up. Thank you, children. Bye bye.
Hi, children. Hope you had enjoyed Madhubani painting. And you will come up with new ideas too. Every time, then you will learn some new paintings or drawings. Whatever might it be, use your creativity in that. Creativity gives more uniqueness to your work. And also, it will develop your skills. As Albert Einstein said, creativity is intelligence having fun. Yes. Use your creativity to have fun. Always remember, enjoy what you're doing. Thank you. Bye-bye, children. Meet you in the next class. Until then.